Exciting stuff, guys. I want to show you a cool new thing that Zoom has that allows you to add what's called a video filter, but it's a custom video filter to your Zoom calls. And what's cool is you can see if I put my hand behind it, that little graphic's on top. So I'm going to show you how to do it. This is a great thing that you could use to have your logo, a picture, a QR code, all sorts of great things that can sit on top of your Zoom call. And I don't want to have a virtual background. This is my real background with this cool little guy on top. So I'm going to show you how to do it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to add this custom video filter in Zoom. So you have to be the admin for your Zoom account, and let's go see how that's done. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to share my screen. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to come into Zoom and you are going to go into your admin part of Zoom, not your personal settings, your admin setting. And you want to click on account setting, and then you want to click on in meeting advanced. So it'll zoom down here and you want to get to where it says, ta-da, video filters. So this is where we're going to add this. Now, just as a caveat, you need to have a Zoom version 5.7.0 or later in order to do this. So if you come down here and you don't see add custom filter, you know you need to do an update. So take care of that first. So assuming everything is good and you do see this, all you do is you, first of all, you're going to have to enable it, but it's probably enabled anyways if you're using other video filters, but make sure that blue is set to on. And then you're going to click add custom filters. And then what you're going to do is you're going to upload your file. So think of it as your logo, a QR code, a graphic, whatever you want to add. And you can all add multiple ones, not just one. So the only thing is you are restricted to 1 megabyte. That's it. So you can't go higher than that. And so if you have multiple ones, you still have to remember your space to do these video filters for custom is 1 megabyte. So you could have 5, but you got to keep your file sizes very, very small if you're going to use this. So let's go ahead. I'm going to choose a file and I have Zoom, and there was I already showed you the teacup. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add 2, just so you see. So the first one is one of my Gillian Bitmos. And this is kind of cool because I can resize this because, of course, I wouldn't want it to take up the whole space. And this shows you, this is you in the middle. So it gives you an idea of, you know, what size you're working with here. So that probably looks pretty good. Just have her up there. And if I want to add, I'm going to add another one over on this side. Come down here where it says add another image to the filter. Click on that. And I'm going to go ahead and add my QR code of my digital business card. So I'll go ahead and get that. So there's that. And I will scoot it over here. And that one I don't even need to resize. So now I think that's kind of balanced. It's good. So there's me in the middle. I got my easy peasy over there and I have my QR code there. So if I click next, this is actually showing me the mobile view, which, you know, sometimes you could be on mobile. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to resize this because I wouldn't want it taking up so much. And I'll come over here and there we go. So there, if I was on mobile, and of course, I want to be on vertical like that. And I will click next. And now I can give it a name. So I could call it Easy Peasy. Maybe I'll just do EP for easy peasy and QR. So I know it's my QR code. And then here's the thumbnail. Now the thumbnail is actually the first graphic that you uploaded to that filter. So that's why it's not showing the barcode. And if I wanted to, I could change the thumbnail. So maybe I want to take a screenshot and have the whole thumbnail in me, and I could have that as a custom thumbnail. But I'm going to just leave it at this for now, and I am going to click save. And there we go. There is my thumbnail. So now if I go out of this and I'm going to stop sharing. Okay, so now we are back in Zoom and I got rid of the teacup because I wanted to show you from scratch what it looked like. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you display these when you're on Zoom. So here, all I have to do is come over here where it is beside the video and I'm going to choose video filter. So I click on that and it brings up this little screen here. And here's all the different filters that come with Zoom that I can use any of these, but this is my custom one. So if I click on that, ta-da, there it is. You can see it. And there it is. And you know, it's awesome because it's like, you know, look, I can touch stuff and it's like, there's my wall. It's my real wall and it's not a virtual background. And what's really cool about the QR code is if you don't know this, you can go ahead and tell people, say I was doing a webinar and I wanted people to, okay, now I want you to go ahead and connect with me afterwards. Well, now I have my digital business card so I can tell people, just go ahead and take your phone and hold it up. And ta-da, it opened up to my digital business card, which is way cool. I just love this. So I know you're going to ask me this. What about if I have a virtual background? Can I still use this? Yes, you can. Super exciting. So I come down here and I click on that little up arrow and then I go to choose virtual background. So let's just go ahead and choose this one. And ta-da, ta-da. Now I don't like virtual backgrounds because look what it does to my hair. It just makes me look like a weird mushroom, but this is kind of cool in that I have my stuff up here. And of course I could choose any virtual background. So maybe I'll just go choose this beach one. That's maybe not quite as weird, but to be honest with you, you just can't do virtual backgrounds with curly hair. It just looks so goofy. It just looks like I'm from another universe. So I'm going to turn off my virtual background and go back to what I was before. And I just think this is way cool. So if you, and you can add another, so you can go back and add another, and I'll show you just real quick how you do that because it's a little tricky. So if I go back to share screen, I'm going to go back and share my screen again. Let's get rid of this guy. So I go back and share my screen. And if I want to add another, you know, I've fiddled around with this. How do I do this? So you come here where it says manage custom filter. So you click there. And of course I could come in here now and I could edit it and I could, well, you know, I want to tweak it and change it around. So if I want to come in and change this one, I would just click here and then I could go in and I can change it. But add a new one, all I have to do is come in here and click add. And now I have the ability to upload a different graphic. So why don't I go ahead and put the teacup back in? So if I put in the teacup, there's the teacup and I can put this, I'm going to just put her back up here again and I will do next. And then we're at the mobile version. So I'll just go in. Come on. Never do things when you're trying to show stuff on a demo. So there that is, and I can click next and I'll call her teacup because that's what it is. I'll leave that thumbnail, click save. And now I have two. So I have two to choose from. So I just close this out. I'm going to stop sharing. I will go back. And so here I have the easy peasy and the barcode, QR code, and I come back up here. Choose my filter. And now I say, I want my teacup. And there you go. I've got my teacup. So I hope you enjoyed this. I think this is so exciting. And just, it's amazing what you can do with Zoom. So if you enjoyed this video tutorial, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. And if you ever need any help with video or whatever, get in touch with me. Thanks.